This is where we live. An earth which is populated with over 5 billion people. Different races, religious beliefs, conflicting ideologies. Some violently antagonistic to each other. It is a world in constant conflict. An earth where over 100 million people have died because of the emergence of one ideology. It is a world that's turning red. To understand Marxist-Leninist thought is to comprehend scientific dialectical materialism. That's the doctrine that every communist follows. It is a method of logic based upon contradictory opposites. Dialectical materialism is taught in every communist school in the world. All actions are derived from dialectical perspectives.
Dialectic progress is progress in the face of opposition or opposed progress. And a simple example is imagine a person leaving a crowded hall. He doesn't just walk straight towards the door, pushing everyone out of the way, but when he comes to a group, then he retreats and goes round it, or moves in a different direction, but he's always got the objective of reaching the door, though his direction at specific times can be away from the door and not towards it. Another example is driving in a nail with a hammer. It's a rather foolish man who brings the hammer crashing down and keeps on pushing. When that blow has spent itself, he reverses the hammer, withdraws it. An individual who does not understand the process, observing this, might say he's given up, he's forsaken the objective. But one who understands the process knows that the withdrawal of the hammer is as essential to the advancing of the nail as the downward thrust.
Marxist-Leninists believe in the scientific inevitability of communist victory. Every Marxist-Leninist feels he's a key part of history in the making. Stalin, Khrushchev, and Mao Zedong all knew that the final victory over capitalist imperialism might never come in their lifetimes. Marxist-Leninism is a modern-day religion, a religion without God. As Lenin put it, atheism is an integral part of Marxism. The laws of God and the philosophy of Marxist-Leninism are totally incompatible. For one thing, the laws of God are unchangeable. God states that man shall not steal, murder, and lie. These are unacceptable immoral acts. The Marxist-Leninist believes everything is relative. Therefore, any act advancing their movement is deemed moral. Any act, belief, or person that thwarts Marxist advance is evil. According to Marxist-Leninism, the end justifies the means. Murder, terror, deceit, subversion, and despicable acts of any kind are nothing more than tools of the trade. Mass murder to the Marxist-Leninist is an absolute necessity in the advancement of their movement towards total victory. There are four steps necessary to capture the mind of a student intellectual. Number one, discredit America as well as other Western nations, undermine their institutions and their values. Two, destroy belief in God and promote humanist standards. Three, fulfill natural desire for idealistic goals with the doctrines of Marxist-Leninism. And four, appeal to ego and intellectual pride. The second step is to destroy any religious beliefs a young person may hold. Evolutionary theory is promoted as scientific fact, and man as nothing more than a graduate animal without any spiritual significance. Man, therefore, is nothing more than matter in motion with no laws or rules governing him other than those that he creates. In 1939, forming a pact with Adolf Hitler, the Soviet armies joined with Germany in the invasion of Poland. Between 1949 and 1961, nearly 3 million Eastern Europeans fled the communist dictators in their homelands through Germany into West Berlin. embarrassed and aware that continuation of this exodus would weaken Soviet regimes in Eastern Europe, initial construction of the Berlin Wall was begun in the summer of 1961. The communist conquest of China was accompanied by an extraordinary worldwide propaganda campaign against President Chiang Kai-shek. Without support from the West, Chiang was soon forced to flee to the island of Formosa, where he formed the nationalist Chinese government in exile. China was quickly brought under the Red Empire, with Mao Zedong at the head of the new Marxist-Leninist government. With still more common borders established, North Vietnam served as a sanctuary from which the communists began infiltrating South Vietnam, Laos, and Cambodia. The savagery in Cambodia was beyond civilized comprehension. John Barron, in Anthony Paul's book, Murder of a Gentle Land, is a gruesome report on the Marxist-Leninist shocking and callous disregard for human life. The killing fields were piled with hundreds of thousands of butchered bodies, and when the death count reached into the millions, 40% of the Cambodian population had been destroyed. With Eastern Europe safely tucked away and Asia well in hand, the Marxist-Leninist movement stepped up their operations for the final phase of Lenin's plan, Europe to Asia to Africa to America. The French, Belgians, English, and Portuguese began a hasty retreat from the African continent. In 1960, France withdrew from 14 of its colonies. Belgium and England soon left the territories they controlled. By the 1970s, Western nations had little influence over the so-called African Third World nations. The Marxist-Leninists, however, had a field day. Soviet socialism, the one consistent Marxist-Leninist failure, created a disastrous famine in Ethiopia. Rhodesia, now called Zimbabwe, had achieved the highest educational and living standards for black Africans. Rhodesia was forced under the Marxist rule of Robert Mugabe in 1980. In 1957, important segments of the American press were drawn to a small band of rough and ragged guerrillas led by the bearded revolutionary Fidel Castro and his henchman Che Guevara. The accounts went out of the way to downgrade Castro's Marxist-Leninist associations. The U.S. government proceeded with an embargo exactly as it had done in the shameful betrayal of Chiang Kai-shek. Without bullets for their guns and stripped of all support, the Batista government fell before the Castro onslaught. Many warnings have been given to America, but few have listened. Maybe communism seemed so far away, so alien to Western thought, that its victory over America seemed ridiculous and laughable. Up until recently, we're losing to our enemy at a rate that should alarm every concerned American. I repeat, on an average of 70,000 people a day, 2.1 million people a month. If we lose America, it will be lost through ignorance. It will be lost by Americans who won't take the time and effort to check the validity of this information. Now please, please join us in an educational effort to inform every free citizen. The choice is yours.